Insomnia 57 with 0.4. Dear friends, how's it going?
It's going good, thank you.
And how's the event been so far?
The event's been really good. I've met so many people as well. Like, I've met as many fans as I possibly could. And it's just been really fun, the entire experience, meeting up with friends and subscribers as well.
I have to say, congratulations, you have over 600,000 followers. Isn't that a bit insane?
It's insane. I never really thought it would kind of get that big and stuff, but I mean, yeah. Every day we're growing, so that's always good. And yeah. I hope to get that million mark as well, so thank you.
Yeah, I hope you do. So you play GTA most of the time?
Yes, GTA and Fallout 4, every time there's like something coming out on that game. Absolutely love that game so much.
Love Fallout 4, but it scares the hell out of me.
It's so scary. There's so many places in that game which you just don't really expect, but it's full of so many secrets as well, and I really want to try and find out like every single thing about that game. So,
I'd like to ask you, I think most of your videos have a lot more of an educational feel to them, and you don't actually put your face into the videos. Why is that? What made you decide?
I show my face occasionally, but I don't really put it in my videos because I don't really see the need to, and as much as I would like to show my face in my videos, it's just not really something I've always kind of thought about doing. If I can just use my voice and people can use that, then that's fine. But it does become like a difference, because when people hear my voice, they'll be like, yeah, I recognize their voice somewhere. But when they see my face, they have to look me up on Twitter or like Google me or something and try and find out if that's the guy or something. But
that's what I did as well.
This is fine. I mean, it's a lot of people do it, and I mean, it's annoying, but at the same time, it's all right, because then I can just weave through crowds and stuff. But I know a lot of friends who can't really do that as much, and like, I can imagine it's fun, but also quite frustrating trying to get point A to point B. Yeah.
I think most of our audience, the majority are gamers, and the majority are also streamers and YouTubers. So what advice would you give to people who want to be as successful as you are?
I would give advice that in order to stay relevant, you have to be relevant. So if you want to get in the scene, you have to keep working every day, and you just can't really stop. You have to try and find out where to make videos and what people want to watch and stuff, and you have to try and make them as good as you possibly can, so you'll be above everyone else in that kind of like topic. So basically, be the best at what you can do in what's relevant, and that should be okay, and just keep working every day.
Lovely words though, I kind of feel inspired. I want to ask you about this one video that you have done recently. Okay. About a 1,000-year ban from Rockstar Games. When I heard that, I was like, really? I have to ask him about this.
It is crazy. Like, we didn't expect this at all. When we saw one person send us an image of it, we thought, oh, it's got to be a fake. So we didn't really do it. But a few other people were sending us images, and we were looking into this, and a few people on the support page also spoke about it. And then for one day, like, Rockstar did a huge ban sweep. And we were reading the forums, and so many people were talking about how they've been banned for like 1,000 years, like 100 years, like just crazy bans and stuff. And
by doing what though?
We don't know. We think it's just, it's Rockstar's way of doing a temporary ban. Like, by doing that, they can do less severe violations. So if someone has committed a violation against their TOS, then they could ban them for a month, year or so, but maybe they've extended the temporary ban to 1,000 years. I don't know, it's something strange, so.
Can you give a few examples of violations?
An example would be, for example, modding stuff in the game or screwing with other players and stuff, doing stuff which you're not allowed to do, for example, like money glitches, or just basically giving other players money or stealing people's money and stuff, just stuff which you're not meant to do, really.
I think you can be considered as a YouTube celebrity. And how has that changed your life, your day-to-day life?
It's a bit more kind of, my social life has gone down surprisingly. Like, a lot of people think YouTube's kind of go partying and I and stuff. I mean, that's not the case. Like, in order to kind of work on your channel, you have to stay in as much as you can, because it's very demanding. Especially in my kind of category, it's all news or it's all kind of the latest thing, so you don't really know when things are going to come out. You have like a rough idea, but it could come out at midnight, it could come out at 4 o'clock in the morning, it could come out like the next morning. So you have to make sure you're there and ready at the time. So it makes you shut yourself inside for a long time. But I mean, it's still fun. Like, I still have like a small group of friends that I can go out with and stuff, but it's definitely changed my life in the fact that it's now my priority. It's what I do full time and like 24/7 pretty much, so.
You're a bit like a journalist. You have to be like on point all the time, yeah. Just catch on the news. I want to ask you about the Lindsay Lohan lawsuit, which is a bit of a controversial topic. What's your thoughts on that?
I think she is definitely extending things as much as she possibly can. I'm amazed that, because the lawsuit was closed and like a year later it was reopened, and I'm amazed. Like, everyone was like, what? So I mean, she's definitely, I give her credit for trying, but she's not going
to
win.
Is it justifiable for her to be saying that? I mean, the pictures do look similar.
They look very similar, and if she does win, and because it's a huge marketing advertising kind of thing, they used it to sell their game, she could take a lot of money from Rockstar, which I'm guessing she is using that very slim chance to do, and also get some publicity as well. But she has sued so many people in the past, and she has failed so many times. She's just basically throwing loads of things at a can or something, waiting for the can to fall over. So, I mean, I don't think she'll win. It's very radical, the idea. But I mean, there's something there. I can see the resemblance, but I don't think Rockstar would have made anything to jeopardize their company like that. So I think they're going to win.
I think you're right as well. Fred, what's your future goals and hopes for your career in this industry?
My future goals is definitely hit that million subscriber. I've been looking at that play button for ages. Like, yeah. So many of my friends have been getting it, and I've been like, one day we'll get it. But also, my future goal is to literally just stick at it, be the best at what I can do, and keep growing, and meet as many of you guys as possible. And like I said, I would like to show my face. I'm just trying to find ways to incorporate that and stuff.
I think you're one of the top GTA YouTubers anyways. I think you will be hitting that point very, very soon.
Thank you
very much for sparing your time. Can we have all of your social media details for our audience?
Yeah, that's fine. My Twitter is at 0.4, and my Instagram is Freddy Pie with Y, I think.
Maybe.
I think so. It's IRE or Y. It's one or the other. My Snapchat is Freddy Pie with the IE, so Freddy Pie. There's a guy on Snapchat who has the Y, and he actually emailed me asking me to stop, like, to tell my fans not to add that one.
Oh.
Because he's getting loads of contact requests from random people.
Oh my god.
Which I find quite funny. So
that is hilarious. He could actually, like, turn that into something as well.
Yeah, like this guy's getting loads of random requests, and he's actually getting annoyed about it. So, I mean, it is what it is, really, but...
He should give that name to you.
Oh yeah, definitely. Or change his name or something. My YouTube is 0.4 Live, and my second channel is 0.5 Live. I don't really do too much on that at the moment. But
I love your videos anyways. Thank you very much for sparing your time.
Thank you. Thank you for the interview as well.
Yeah. And I was with Fred 0.4. This is Yasmin Alice from CloudMoves TV. Bye guys.